Hello everyone, I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. So you want to get Wi-Fi 6 on your home network, but you don't want to buy a very expensive router. Well, you're in luck, because in this video, I want to show you the most affordable way to get Wi-Fi 6 on your home network, while at the same time not compromising on the features and also on the functionalities that Wi-Fi 6 provides. So in this video, I'm going to show you this Wi-Fi 6 router from Tenda. This is the RX2 Pro router, and it is an AX1500 router. I'm gonna show you the router up close, so for you to see what are the ports that are on this router, and also what comes in the box. I'm gonna be talking about the specifications of this router, but most importantly, I'm gonna be testing the speed and the range of this router against its big brother from Tenda. So this is the AX3000 router, and this test, the speed test and the range test, is for you to be able to determine if the speed of this RX2 Pro is sufficient for you and if the range it covers is also sufficient for you. So for you to be able to make your choice if an entry-level Wi-Fi 6 router will be sufficient for you or you'll be better off with a faster Wi-Fi 6 router. So let me start by showing you the RX2 Pro up close. So let me open the router very quickly. So this is everything that comes with the router. You have the power adapter, some documentation, an Ethernet cable, and you have the router. It has five antennas. On the back of the router, you have the power port. You have this button here. It is for WPS and for reset. And this is the WAN port. It is 1 gigabits per second speed. And these here are the LAN ports, and they are also 1 gigabits per second each. And this port here is for the IPTV if you want to connect an IPTV directly to it. So these are all the ports on this router. I talked about the ports of this router. Let me cover the other specifications. This is a Wi-Fi 6 AX1500 router. It has a dual band capability, 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. On the 5 GHz band, the speed goes up to 1200 megabits per second. And on the 2.4 GHz band, the speed goes up to 300 megabits per second. It has MIMO and OFDMA technologies. It has also basic parental control, and it also has WPA3 for the Wi-Fi connection security. So it covers the basic Wi-Fi 6 capabilities. Before performing the speed and range tests against the RX9 Pro router, I wanted to tell you that if you wanna see how to set up this router, I've made previously a video on how to set up a Tenda router from A to Z. You can find this video on the link in the description if you wanna check it out. Also, if you want to check out this router, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage, and this is at no cost to you. So now let's go and perform the speed and range tests. The first test I'm doing is copying a large file between two PCs connected with Wi-Fi 6 to the network. And here you notice that the Tenda RX2 Pro is much slower than the Tenda RX9 Pro. It is averaging only 11 megabytes per second, whereas the RX9 Pro is averaging 38 megabytes per second. And in this test, the RX2 Pro shows its limits compared to the faster RX9 Pro. Now I'm testing the internet speed. I don't have any devices connected to the internet except for my PC, so that the speed test will be accurate. I have a download speed of 120 megabits per second, and I have an upload speed of 20 megabits per second. And here both routers are giving their full potential, and I'm getting the full speed that I have on my internet. In this test, I loaded my internet connection with many devices connected to the internet. I have two TVs streaming 4K movies, I have two iPads streaming full HD videos, and I have my Amazon Echo playing music. And this is to see how these two routers will cope when the internet connection is congested. And frankly, both routers are performing very well, with a very slight advantage for the RX9 Pro that is averaging 97 megabits per second, whereas the RX2 Pro is averaging 92 megabits per second. Now I'm performing the range test. I live in an apartment building, so I went out of my apartment into the hallway and I started walking, and the RX9 Pro started cutting at the 40 yards mark, and it was averaging almost 5.4 megabits per second download speed, whereas the RX2 Pro continued until the 50 yards mark and it was averaging almost 7 megabits per second. And this is a clear advantage for the RX2 Pro in the range test. Now let me tell you the pros and cons of this router and whether I recommend it or not. The pros are, this is an affordable Wi-Fi 6 router. It has a good internet performance, and it has an excellent range, and it covers the basic features and functions of a Wi-Fi 6 network. Now, the cons are that this router doesn't have the 160 MHz channel, and the WPA3 security on this router works only on the 5 GHz band, and it doesn't even exist on the 2.4 GHz band. And this router also is very slow when it comes to LAN connections, so PCs that are connected to the LAN communicate slowly through this router. And also, this router doesn't have a USB port. Now, would I recommend this router? It all depends on the use cases that you're gonna use this router in. If you only need to build an affordable Wi-Fi 6 network so that you can access the internet, and also you need like a good range router, this router is highly recommended. But in one case, I don't recommend this router, is that if you have many PCs on your network and these PCs need to communicate with each other and transfer large files, this router is not recommended in this case because you saw in the tests, the file copy was a bit slow. I hope that my video will help you in your choice of getting an affordable Wi-Fi 6 router, whether it is the standard RX2 Pro or other Wi-Fi 6 router. If you liked my video, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. I want to thank you all for watching, and see you in the next video.